Okay, here we are. Time to stick the jet drives in, guys. And I've got a new mic. Hopefully that's working. Splashed out a little bit. New lens, new mic. Here we are. I'm going to just basically use a bit of black silicone here around these lips. I'm going to go generous. I don't want it problems after. This will allow me then to carbon the bottom. And I'm just going to use a generous amount, and then I'll clean up inside with some white spirit and some paper towel. So let's get that going, shall we? This is a bit of a moment. It's a bit of a moment. I thought I'd show you. Not any moaning. Hey? Get the old glue coming out the end here. Oh, there it is. On the old top of the fridge. People, I'm mixing my resin. It's warm today, so I don't want to be lingering too long here before it starts to bloody go. I've laid my 50 centimeter wide cloth on, which comes just to the top of the rail, kind of. So I'm going to wet the whole lot. I'll let it go off and then I'll trim. I've got my hatches in. I'm going to try and hit everything in one go here. I'm going to start a little bit with these hatches. Let that soak into these holes first. Hopefully this works out. I didn't really want to have to go in again to do these hatches, so I'll try and do it all in one hit here. Should be okay. These are kind of the funny sort of shapes here, so I'm going to push these down and in. I've already pre-cut some of my special non-stick film. That can go on. And then I have some plastic doodads. As I push them in, it all kind of bows up funny. So I'm hoping we'll get these formed first, you know, and then I can start. So yeah, guys, there we go. I'm gonna stand about, I'm gonna piddle, make sure as we're drying, tacking, we're pushed in. Oh, there's a big old, what's they called? Frulon. Got me spray ready, mate. People, for the beasts, they come on in. Hornets, we get hornets a lot. And I hate hornets. Been stung by, you know, by a hornet. It is not fun. But I might have a bubble or two that I need to deal with around these hatches here. It's actually worked fairly well for me. Perfect amount of resin. So I'll cut the nose, I'll wrap that where I want it, and I will keep pushing and pulling and making sure we are soaked everywhere. This is the last piece going on. Looking nice, eh? Looking nice, guys. Look at that. There I am. So I'll keep the brush handy in the end. And I'll be back. I'll be back with more, guys, after I show you a little look round once it's trimmed and sorted out. All right.
All right, I've done the resin coat. Kind of pulled up in place. I think I went a bit heavy. It
You see, I've sort of got holes everywhere in the resin there where it's pooled on me. It's going to get all sanded right back to flat, and then any problems, I'll go again with a lighter coat of resin. Just those sort of holy bits anyway. A bit of tape to protect where I don't want to sand, because I had a cut the bubble ups on this rail. And I've done the top. Okay, there's the top. This I did lighter, and it's come out a lot better. And just barely covered the weave. That's gonna get a light sand, and then I'm gonna go again. So the way to go, guys, for me is a couple of coats, I guess. So I'm gonna give it a good old sand, go through the grit, start with a heavy grit, kind of a 120-ish grit, and then I'll go with a bit of 240, and that'll be good to take another coat of resin. And then the very final sand I give it will be in the 400 sort of range, just to really get it ready to paint what I'm gonna paint on there.